try to spin it however you want to spin it, but we've got the info. We've got the goods. Anyway, Donald Trump's next response. Tell me if you even understand what this even means. Who sends a billion-dollar blimp with the most sophisticated equipment in the world and large enough to hold 10 cars or 3 large buses into a complex pattern over the United States without it quite possibly being manned, such as the manned spacecraft? China should have been called to ask. If no, shoot it down. If yes, negotiate the greatest deal ever. Not even early signs of dementia. And I don't want to even give him excuses here, but what the hell is he even saying there? China should have been called to ask. If no, shoot it down. If yes, negotiate the greatest deal. What is he talking about? A man balloons me? I genuinely have no clue what he's saying there, other than that he is a disgusting individual who just says a bunch of words and just reveals each day what a freaking idiot he is. And finally,
the giant in the skies, the largest airliner in the world. This is the Antonov AN-225 Maria, the world's largest cargo aircraft ever built. The plane was a modern engineering marvel, able to transport up to 250 tons of cargo. The Maria attracted a high degree of public interest, attaining a global following due to its size and uniqueness. However, it has also achieved 214 other national and 124 international records, including the airlift of the most significant payload ever at 279 tons. Antonov AN-225 was initially intended to take the Soviet Buran space shuttle back from its landing site to the Baikonur spaceport in Kazakhstan. After the end of the space program, Antonov Airlines converted the AN-225 into a cargo plane. The AN-225 rose to be the workhorse of the Antonov Airlines fleet as it began carrying cargo that was once thought impossible to move by air, including 130-ton generators, diesel locomotives, and wind turbine blades. Here is the cockpit, located just above the main cargo bay, to ensure the aircraft has as much capacity as possible for carrying cargo. You must ascend a ladder to enter the cockpit because the main deck is reserved for the cargo bay. The nose of the aircraft is a cargo door, which allows maximum loading size of cargo. The upper deck with a cockpit, crew rest cabin, and cabin for accompanying personnel, each with a maximum thrust capacity of 229.5 kilonewtons. The last mission of the AN-225 was from February 2nd through 5th, 2022, where it was to collect 90 tons of COVID-19 test kits from Tianjin, China, and deliver them to Billund in Denmark. While being stored in a hangar in Hostomel, Ukraine, during this time the war between Russia and Ukraine broke out and the airfield was raided by Russian troops. Eventually, it was discovered that the AN-225 was destroyed during the Battle of Antonov Airport. Meanwhile, debris of the AN-225 remains in the hangar where it was destroyed. In May 2022, Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky said he plans to have the plane rebuilt and make it a tribute to all the Ukrainian pilots who died during the Russian-Ukraine war. The Antonov AN-225 is such a phenomenon. That is why it is no surprise that aviation fans around the world frequently visit airports to observe the plane's scheduled arrivals. If you enjoyed this video, hit that subscribe button and the bell so you're notified when I make a new video. For more updates and suggestions, check out Learn From The Base social medias. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you learned a lot, and I will see you next time.